Get ready to match the stars. George Kennedy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Loretta Swit, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Look at these beautiful people here. How are you feeling, George?
Sensational.
Is everyone quite ready?
Yeah. Ready?
All ready?
Yep.
All right, then let's all give a brisk round of applause to our two players, Brianne Leary and Carrie Shore. This little lady is the current champion. She has won a bundle of money, $9,050. Now, what are you going to do with that money?
Pay some bills.
Going to pay some bills?
Yes.
You mean to tell me you've got $9,000 worth of bills?
No.
Close. Oh, I see. Well, I'm glad we're going to be able to furnish that money to do that. And Carrie Shore here is challenging her. We just had a chance to meet you, right?
Right.
And find out where you're from. Would you repeat some of that information so that people know?
Okay, I'm originally from New York.
Yep.
And now living out in Los Angeles.
Right.
Married. And have a lovely wife named Kathy. And I ski and play beach volleyball.
Right. Okay, and you ski in the northern part of California.
Right.
All right, good luck to both of you. We'll begin in a moment or so, right after we do a little business with America. Here we go. Push the button, round one questions. Carrie, you may have A or B.
I'll try B.
B it is. New game. Here we go. Tech said, boy, am I mad. Last night somebody took my 10-gallon hat and filled it with 10 gallons of blank. My man. Somebody took my 10-gallon hat and filled it full of 10 gallons of blank. Blank.
Take this to the cashier.
Oh, yes. How much is it worth? Oh, not bad. Ready? Are you ready? Fine. What? Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Little kiss for Loretta Swit, who's so good on MASH. She's just a delight.
Amen.
As George Kennedy is on The Blue Knight, and what's her name is on the Mary Tyler Moore Show there. You ready, Carrie?
I think so.
Tech said, boy, am I mad. Last night somebody took my 10-gallon hat and filled it with 10 gallons of...
cow waste.
He ain't no country boy.
He's my brother.
He's my brother, no. Country boys say cow chips. They don't say cow waste. What do you say, George?
Man-oor.
Man-oor. Okay. What do you say?
This is a match. Manure.
Well, no, wait a minute. She scratched out the word horse at the last second there. And what do you say, Charles?
I went a whole other route. I said Bach beer.
Bach beer.
Good for you.
He would appreciate that, wouldn't he? That wouldn't make him mad.
That's
now, would
right.
It, Loretta?
Yeah, no, but I made it even stronger. I made it bourbon.
Bourbon.
I thought he should have fun.
Yes, very good.
I think he'd be pleased with beer and bourbon, wouldn't he?
Right. Mm. Shot in a beer?
I don't know how you'd feel about tinkle.
Well...
I'll drink
that. That's what made him mad. Yes, sirree. He finally did get mad. What do you say, Miss Betty?
Well, now, wait a minute. Let's consider Richard's answer. I mean, that's not... if that isn't waste, I don't know who wants to save it. You know, I mean, I think that...
doctors do.
Yes. Well, it is the way it is, yes.
I don't know whether I matched Carrie or Charles. I said tinkle.
All right. So there you are. One for you, Carrie, and now let's see how Brianne does with her first round question, which reads as follows. The waiter said... our chef really puts himself into his cooking, and the customer said, I know, I just found his blank in my stew. The waiter said, our chef really puts himself into his cooking, and the customer said, I know, I just found his blank in my stew.
I gotta go for it.
Okay. Right. Brett's ready. Ready?
Wait a minute, hon.
Okay.
I'm hurrying.
Okay, while you're writing, I'll just read it to Brianne so she gets a hang of it. The waiter said, "Our chef really puts himself into his cooking." And the customer said, "I know. I just found his blank in my stew."
Shorts.
What?
Shorts.
Shorts? Shorts?
Well, he was a short order cook.
He was a short order cook. Go ahead, George.
Apologize.
That was a sock and trade. No, I had a socks going.
Socks. You said socks. All right, Brett, what do you say?
Have you noticed that Betty's new Shirley Temple cut? She looks like an... Sing on the good ship lollipop and stop getting
Leave her alone,
trouble.
Show us your answer.
I said it's pretty black socks and garters.
Pretty black socks and garters. Oh, boy. Charles?
The good ship lollipop was not a boat, you know.
No?
It was an airplane. Oh. Shoe.
Shoe. We're looking for a pair of shorts. The waiter said our chef really puts himself in his cooking, and the customer said, "I know, I just found his blank in my stew," and she said, "Shorts."
I said hairpiece.
Hairpiece.
Okay. Like tossing a salad and bent over and...
Howard Cosell was the salad chef.
German chef. Hairpiece.
Uh-huh.
German chef. Hairpiece, I see. Okay. What have... He tore up your cards. Oh, that rascal.
Sock.
So, the score is 1-0, favor the challenger, Kerry Shore, at the end of round one. Round two coming up after this. Here we go, round two coming up. And, Kerry, you may have A or B.
I'll try A this time.
A. All right. You matched one person, that was George. The rest of you, if you would please respond to this. Thomas Alva Edison said, "It's tough being an inventor when your mother is a klutz." Yesterday, she sat on my first blank. Thomas Alva Edison. You know who he was. But don't say. But think about him. He said, "It's tough being an inventor when your mother is a klutz. Yesterday, she sat on my first blank." Were you going to change your mind?
Yeah.
Oh, that's very good. Terrific. Okay. While Brett is finishing writing, I'll walk over to here, Kerry.
I'm finished.
All right, Kerry, I'll read it to you. Thomas Alva Edison said, "It's tough being an inventor when your mother is a klutz." You know what a klutz is?
Sure do.
Yesterday, she sat on my first blank.
Light bulb.
Yeah. Light bulb is good. He came up with a good one, Brett. He said light bulb.
He did.
Yes, he did.
And it lit up like a Broadway sign. Light bulb.
Light bulb. That's one for him, Charles.
Yay!
Yay! Two for you, Kerry. You're up to three now. Loretta?
I was going to write light socket, and then I changed it back
to light bulb. Yes, good. So you're up to four now, Kerry. You got two more to go down here in this tier. What do you say, Richard?
What else did he invent?
Well, he invented the phonograph. He invented the motion picture camera and the projector and the stock ticker, the thing that the ticker tape comes through on. He was really quite a remarkable man.
There wasn't a stock market then, was it?
Oh, yes, there was.
But he was ready when it came along.
Light bulb.
Yes, a light bulb. What do you say, Miss Betty?
His mother was just glowing with pride.
The light bulb. He's got them all. You ready to go to work here?
Yeah.
All right, listen carefully. Brian, got to match everybody now to stay in the game. Here we go. Harvey ran out of denture grip, so instead he used super glue. The glue held his dentures in so tight he needed a blank to get them out. Used super glue on his dentures, held them in so tight, needed a blank to get them out.
Blank.
Right. Okay, bottom tier is ready.
Honey, come here, sweetie.
Yes. Yes, that's perfect. Yes, excellent.
What you used for that kind of...
Gosh. Come on, George.
Okay.
Whoops,
don't okay.
No, I won't. Thank you. All right, Brianne, are you ready?
Yeah.
Harvey ran out of denture grip, so instead he used super glue. The glue held his dentures in so tight he needed a blank to get them out.
Crowbar.
Crowbar is good. All right.
But it is good.
Crowbar. Little kid came up with a good answer there, George.
Well, I'm
what the big kid?
Close. Pickaxe.
Pickaxe. All right, so that means Kerry Shore wins the game. What the rest of you have? Crowbar. Fired. Okay, come on down, Kerry. Congratulations. Okay, stand around over there. What's that?
I said, that's super. I've got
that's
so
super.
Much.
How much money have you got now?
A lot of money.
$9,050 and our that's best super. Wishes. Brianne Leary. Goodbye. Bye. Here we are. Now listen, young fella, you could win a lot of money here, you know?
I know it.
Are you ready for it?
Ready to go.
All right, we'll begin right now, Kerry. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Pickled blank. Now you get $500 if you match the answer they gave most often. $250 if you match their second most frequent response. And then $100 if you team up with their third most popular answer. Let's see what help we'll get from our celebrities.
Richard.
How about a pickled herring?
Pickled herring? Okay.
Betty.
Oh, I was afraid you were going to do that, Gary. The herring I had, pickled walnuts.
What?
Pickled walnuts.
There is no such
yes,
thing as
there
pickled
is.
Walnuts.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Just
there
not
is.
Very common.
I have them right now at home.
Blah, I wouldn't eat them on a bet.
I didn't ask you to eat
them. You don't put them on a bet, silly.
Okay.
Charles.
How about pickled beets?
So, well, then you got pickled herring, pickled walnuts, and pickled beets. You want one of those?
Yeah, I think I'll go with pickled herring.
He wants a Bissell pickle herring. All right, let's find out if pickled herring is up there. And if so, where may we see the $100 response? Pickled beets is a good answer. That was Charles. Let's see if we get a little herring out of the $250 response. Pig's feet.
Sure.
Walnuts is in.
You bet.
You mean walnuts? It's going to be walnuts, right? Pickled walnuts. Oh, yeah. Let's see if we get a little herring with a little bagel and sweet butter under the $500 number. Yes, we do. Yeah. Attaboy, Kerry. You got 600 bucks now. And you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. But we can't give you the money until you match one celebrity. This has to be an exact match. So you choose one now. Someone you think you got a little empathy with. Some ESP flowing between you and that individual.
I'll go with Richard.
Okay.
Pickled walnut.
No, we've passed that already.
Oh.
Yes, already we finished that. All right.
Pickled walnut.
Here it is, the $5,000 question. Carrie reads as follows. Army blank. Army blank. Army blank. Now he's finished. Kerry, give us an answer which you think will match his. Get your ESP flowing over to him, and you'll collect the $5,000. What do you say to that? Army
cot.
Cut?
Cot.
Oh, army cot. Yeah, that's a common item. Most households have one when an spare guest shows up. All right, Richard, he says army cot will match you for $5,000. What do you say to that?
There were a million. Army camp, right, army. You know, I said, my mother wears army boots.
Army boots. Audience,
army
what would you
Navy.
Have said? Army, Navy, a little bit of everything there. All right, that is a tough one indeed. Now, Kerry, you picked up some money. You got $600 here. You're going to meet another player a little bit later. Right now, we've got a little message for you. Hurry back.
George,
would you all look over here and applaud briskly our new player, Johnny Biedelman.
Deputy Sheriff?
Yes.
Johnny Biedelman. I'd swear I said that's Johnny Biedelman. And it is indeed. Where are you from, Johnny?
Los Angeles.
What do you do, if anything?
I'm a library clerk. I've been
you
dealing
are.
In library services for, 23 years.
Do you read a lot?
Yes.
I guess you do. I mean, for pleasure.
Yes.
Well, that's marvelous. And you have an opportunity to do that because you're connected with a library.
Yes.
Anything else you want to tell us about Johnny Biedelman?
Well, I'm married and I have 3 children. And my hobby is making wine.
Making wine?
Yes.
Good girl. You make it from the essence, or do you squeeze your own grapes?
Well, I make my favorite and my expertise is fig wine.
Fig wine. You're under arrest, Johnny. All right. Good luck to you, Johnny. You have a choice here of A or B in round one.
I'll take B.
B it is for Beetleman. Beetleman. Hey, did you hear about the Double Mint Twins?
No.
Let me tell you about the Double Mint Twins. When they posed nude for the magazine centerfold, they got double blank.
Did I miss something?
Again.
When they posed nude for the magazine, they got
the double mint.
When they posed nude for the magazine centerfold, they got double. I think we could nail ours. Oh, I can't.
You got it. You got a couple of good ones there. Very good, George. Put that in the slot and away we go.
Just a minute, Bob.
All right, I'll walk over here to Johnny Beetleman and read it to her one time while they're finishing writing. Don't say your answer yet. I say to you, Johnny, did you hear about the Doublemint twins?
When Charles they posed, hasn't finished.
He's, Charles, what are you doing? All right. When they posed nude for the magazine centerfold, they got double blank.
Staple.
Double staple. Yes. You read those magazines? She reads a lot, you see.
What did she say?
She said double stapled. You know, that's the Mortsal's old joke. He's had a girl, she had a staple here and a staple there, a picture of his girlfriend. What do you say?
I thought they got double exposed.
Double exposed, is that a good answer? Very good.
That's a terrific answer.
It's excellent.
Yes. I thought I had the definitive answer.
What do you got?
Turns out I'm wrong. I said they got double pneumonia.
Well, that's the second. I mean, I think that's as good on a par with that one. They're both very good. Yes, Charles.
I went a clean route. They got double pay.
Clean but dumb, Charles. Okay.
I thought it was sweet.
Dude, what's sweet? When they posed nude for the magazine centerfold, they got double stapled.
Exposed.
Exposed. That seems to be the answer, Johnny. What do you say, Richard?
Double exposure.
Double exposure.
Double your pleasure, double your fun with Doublemint, double pneumonia.
Double pneumonia there.
That doesn't rhyme.
Okay, Carrie, we've got one for you coming up. Here it is. 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle said...
I didn't hear that.
Hold on. I think my wife is out to get me. For my birthday, she gave me a blank. I think my wife is out to get me. For my birthday, she gave me a blank. Put something on the card, son.
Got it.
Oh,
that's
good.
Nice. Isn't that nice?
That's very nice.
Oh, I like that.
Okay. Ready over there? Now, Terry, 102-year-old Mr. Periwinkle said,
I think my wife is out to get me. For my birthday, she gave me a...
waterbed.
A waterbed. Ha! Funny answer. George, what's yours?
No, I couldn't think of it. Jogging suit.
Jogging suit is a good response. Brett?
I said bicycle.
Bicycle, another good one. Get his cardiovascular system going. Charles?
Gravestone.
Gravestone. All right, Loretta, what'd you say?
Well... she's a pretty terrific lady, and I said kiss, because that would really...
Oh, that would arouse...
18-year-old girl.
That'll do it every time. Wow. Betty? A blonde 18-year-old girl. So there we are at the end of round one with no score, and before we go any further, we've got to do a little business with you. Well, you were grand, and some of you will return next week, and some of you won't.
Yikes.
Ever.
And no, you were all terrific, and we'll look forward to seeing all of you at some time in the near future. And meanwhile, next time we get together, these other celebrities will be here.
Bob Barker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty Duke-Aston, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly.
Gene Rayburn asking you to join us next time for Match Game 76. So long.